We want to talk a little bit about derivatives of exponential functions. This one is taken from your textbook, and it says the management of a large chain of frozen yogurt stores in New England believes that T days after the end of an advertising campaign, the volume of sales is approximated by, and then this equation, volume. Is equal to 65,000 plus 65,000 e to the negative 0.46 times t. At what rate is the sales volume changing one day after the end of the campaign? And what about 6 days after the end of the campaign? Okay, so the question does talk about, and here's my keyword. How is volume changing, which involves the derivative? So I want to take the derivative of volume, v prime of t. 65,000, the derivative is 0. Then I get 65,000 e to the same thing, right? Negative 0.46 t times the derivative of the inside, which is 0.46. Let me, on my calculator now, combine these two terms and multiply those together. I get negative 29,900, and then e to the negative 0.46 t for the derivative. Okay? So now we'll answer these questions. At what rate is the sales volume changing one day after the campaign? One day I need to plug in t is equal to 1. So I'll plug that in. V prime of 1. Negative 29,900 e to the negative 0.46 times 1. Negative 18,875.38. So, in interpreting this result, it says that volume is changing, the volume of sales is changing by $18,000 and is decreasing. So, sales decrease by $18,875 one day after the campaign. Campaign ends. Okay. 6 days, same thing. Except I'm going to plug in 6. So let's see. And really, the idea is that the 6 days will tell me how it's changing from day 5 to day 6. So let's just be clear about that. V prime of t, negative 29,900, e to the negative 0.46 times 6. And that is negative $1,892.42. So from day 5 to day 6, or which I plugged in 6, so this would be from day 6 to day 7. Sales volume again decreases by about I already used decreases by about $1,892.42. Okay. Let's look at another application. And it says if a person is prescribed a dose of 5 milligrams of valium, the amount of valium in a person's bloodstream at any time t can be modeled with this exponential decay function. How much in valium remains in the person's bloodstream after 5 hours of taking this dose? So that's just a of 5. I just plug in 5 for in this original function and put that into my calculator. 5e to the -0.0144 times 5, and I get 4.65, and it's in milligrams, right? And in a sentence, there are 4.65 milligrams of valium in a person's bloodstream. Five hours after taking a 5 milligram dose. Okay. How long will it take the 5 milligrams of valium to decay to 1.25 milligrams in a person's bloodstream? Okay, so again, this is a question about how long it takes the original function to get to 1.25. I'm just going to set this 1.25 milligrams equal to here and solve for time. Okay, so my first step, if I want to convert this to a log equation in order to get that t out, I have to get this by itself, so I divide both sides by 5. I get 0.25 is equal to e to the -0.0144t. I'll convert this to a log equation, which is natural log of 0.25 is -0.0144t, and then divide both sides by this coefficient. So t is natural log of 0.25 all divided by this -0.0144. Let me plug that into my calculator. And that's about 96. So in a sentence, it takes 96 hours for the amount of blood, for the amount of valium to decrease to 1.25 milligrams. Okay. Part C, at what rate is the amount of valium decaying 1 hour after the dose is changing? Okay, so here we see this change in language. At what rate is the decay happening? This is definitely a decay model. So at what rate is this happening? And that indicates that I need to use the derivative. So let's go down and we'll take the derivative of this function. And I'm thinking about it after 1 hour. So a of t, this is part C, 5e to the -0.0144t. And I want to find a prime of t at 1, at t equals 1. So the derivative of this is 5e to the same thing, right? E to the u, and then derivative of the inside, which is just -0.0144. And again, I'm going to combine these two things that are multiplied outside this e. 5 times -0.072 e to the -0.01t. And then it's asking how the change rate is changing at time is equal to 1 hour. So I'll plug 1 into this function. E to the negative 0.0144. And I get a prime of 1 is negative 0.070. If I round, that should be 10 right there. And so at 1 hour, or after 1 hour, the amount of volume in a person's bloodstream is decaying at a rate of 0.0710 milligrams per hour. Okay, so just be careful of language here in these word problems. Some of them definitely will just be asking about the basic model, and some of them will be asking about the derivative. But please let me know if you have questions.